Hey Deepak,
Morning, good
good
afternoon,
morning, how are you?
Sharsha. I hope you're doing well and staying safe, staying healthy, staying at home.
Yes, that's the new normal, right?
Absolutely. And in this new normal, I think everything has changed. So has things in our domain of software testing. Although there are certain things which still remains as challenges for our customers, and in such times when you are facing such a huge challenge of making your workforce work from home, I think legacy tools are failing them. I feel that specifically from testing perspective, having a tool in the SaaS mode or in a cloud would have served the purpose better. Having a lightweight tool would have done a much better job, I think. That's what my thinking is. What do you think about that?
Oh, that is true, right? With cloud being the new normal, right? You need a tool, or not just a tool, right? You need a whole ecosystem, right? That can enable quick turnaround times, quick access for the whole organization, right? And that's where the legacy tools, which have been conventionally non-cloud based, right? I would say, and not open for employees to be accessed from their home network and all those challenges, those are already there. And now, with the way the business is going to be driven, right, with low touch with your end customers, and that's where this whole new generation tools and the processes are going to evolve, right? And legacy tools, they don't evolve as fast as we would like it to be.
Absolutely. And so extending that discussion, what do you think, in terms of your customers? Because I'm sure at this point in time, your existing customers and new customers would be looking for a certain solution. And what you are hearing from them, specifically on this issue of tool being a bottleneck for them.
Oh, definitely, right? So tool being a bottleneck is already there. And even before this thing whole happened, right, we were seeing that that the tool and legacy tools are being a bottleneck for them, right? And that's why we were in conversation with larger enterprises that they wanted to enable new generation tools for their organization, right, where they are adopting to agile, they're adopting to DevOps. And that's where the legacy systems fail, right? Integrations with the agile systems, integration with DevOps tools. But with this whole COVID thing, right, that ask has accelerated because now they need to adopt to this agile fashion or DevOps processes in much more accelerated manner, right? So yeah, it has definitely increased.
Interesting. I think there's one more point that I've been reading and hearing from my peers in the industry is that there is a huge impetus in going digital now, because you need to reach out to your customers, and physical touch points are no more relevant. And I've also heard that this is going to take a while before this social distancing thing goes away, and this new normal becomes maybe the old normal that we used to live. Do you think that will drive more companies to go towards agile and DevOps tool sets, and how would that translate for QA teams?
Sure, right. So, like with agile transformation or digital transformation, right? Digital transformation is a must now. And we saw that during this whole COVID-19 time that the transportation industry, which is not heavily agile centric, right? They had to be agile in order to fulfill the needs or the demands of this new normal, right? They had to, the supply chain had to evolve as well, right? Mm-hmm. So all those demands or the need of the hour pushes the whole industry to be agile centric, right? Mm-hmm. And in order to get to agile, it's very essential that you have the right tools and processes, because your processes are driven by tools. And in order to have those processes well defined, you need to have the right tools.
Mm-hmm.
The legacy tools were not defined, keeping in mind the agile or digital transformation, right? And that's where I feel new generation tools, like say Jira, right? You look at Atlassian, they have become a new normal, or I would say a new benchmark for agile processes, right? If you want to do any kind of software process or any agile process, then Jira is a must-have tool.
Mm-hmm.
And with this whole work-from-home situation for everyone, Jira has seen a surge in number of users. So, and that tells us that agile is the new way that all the industries and all the organizations are adopting. Mm-hmm. And when we talk about QA, right, QA also needs to adapt to that. They cannot have that, hey, I'm going to test, my test cycle is going to be 2 weeks, and after that, I'm going to give out the results for the production release, right?
Mm-hmm.
The in-sprint testing, which is the need of the hour, also relies on the tools, right? Whether it's manual testing or automation testing you have. So that is where I see the tools or agile test management tools will play an important role in helping QA teams to realize the same amount of productivity that is required for your, say, engineering teams.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So what about the sunk cost mindset? Because, you know, a lot of these organizations have already invested a lot into this legacy tools. They have set up processes around it. They've set up, you know, infrastructure around it. Doing away with that infrastructure, there is always a mindset bottleneck which says that, okay, you know, we have already invested so much. Why do we have to invest something extra? So how do you really, counter that argument, Harsha?
Sure. I feel that that is the cost of transformation. Right, it's when you are transforming from an old Honda Civic to say a new Tesla Model S, there is going to be a cost of transformation. But in the long run, if you look at it, right, there will be savings. I'll be saving on gas, I'll be saving on maintenance, which is a big savings in the long run, right? So, and this is an analogy that I always give to my customers as well. But when you look at, say, you're driving your old car, it's going to give you high maintenance cost.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to have high gasoline cost. And it's the same with your legacy systems, right? Your legacy systems are going to have those high maintenance costs. Your teams are working to make that system work with the new processes. So you're investing more time in your legacy systems to make it work for things that are not relevant in today's day and age, right? And that's where the new tools, which already come with those support for new processes and new technology, will give you a head start in achieving what you need to achieve, right? As part of the digital transformation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think, you know, one more thing that I always feel that, you know, so I was reading this report by Gartner, and they said that 60 to 70% of, cost of IT departments across, you know, large organizations are spent towards maintenance of, existing or old software. And I think, you know, you really pointed out the right point that, you know, in this current challenge, that everybody is facing, I think, you know, that costs can be replaced with an investment into a new agile DevOps tools which can drive the future for you and not you know, keep you stuck with the past as such.
And that is the new thinking, right? When I talk about say I talk about the financial industry, right? Then they have this old HP quality center or QTP kind of licenses for their automation processes or test management processes. Now, with this whole new agile and DevOps ideology, right, they have to evolve in getting all these tools for their global teams in the cloud, right? You cannot have it bogged down within their own servers and environment. And that's where they are migrating to the cloud ideology or mindset. They do have regulations, but if the right regulations and rules are applied, then the cloud is definitely going to give them a head start in giving their employees access to this new generation tools. And that's where I feel, say, tools like Humetry or say even Jira, which is an agile agile project management tool, and Humetry, which is a agile test management tool, will excel because it gives the users that agile processes support as well as access from the cloud.
Yes, that's true. That's true. And I think, you know, so, you know, I was attending the Atlassian Virtual Summit, remote summit recently. And I, you know, the new philosophy or the new framework that they've brought for cloud, for Jira and Confluence, I think that that takes care of a lot of, you know, compliance issues as such. And I think, you know, Humetry is also well integrated with that kind of an ecosystem, as well as, you know, we already have a lot of compliance like e-signature taken care of within our ecosystem. And in terms of data also, we have, you know, back-end data centers which are available in different geographies, and that kind of helps in this cause overall. Another important factor that everybody talks about is it's migration. Right. I think migration gives you migraine pains, you know. and I think, you know, you want to avoid those headaches. How do you think that, you know, specifically Humetry kind of a tool helps, you know, in that kind of a situation?
So migration is always painful, right? And I think I gave this analogy last time as well, that if you're migrating from San Francisco to New York, there's always going to be a migration pain. But that's an ideology that I need to migrate for the better, right? And that's where, if you have that ideology, then migration becomes a lot easier. And with Humetry, right, we have the tools and technologies or utilities that help with this whole migration process, right? Humetry has done these migrations multiple times for multiple customers, right? So we have built this utility which migrates all your test artifacts from your legacy systems, whether it's an IBM tool or an HP tool, so Quality Center or ALM or even say IBM Rational. We have utilities built in which will help you migrate your test artifacts from your legacy tool to Humetry, so you don't lose any data, as well as that process becomes seamless.
Interesting. So let's talk a little bit more about migration. So let's say I'm a legacy customer. Now I want to move into a new age tool like, you know, Humetry, because I'm, you know, it's my need of the hour. What are the different, you know, processes or frameworks for migration which are available, you know, apart from the tools that you talked about? Or utilities that you talked about.
So there are multiple ways you can do it, right? We have APIs available for that. We have the utility which I talked about, as well as there is an Excel import export functionality which is available as well, right? So you can pick and choose what is an ideal methodology for you. large enterprises, they usually go with the utility because that makes their they have hundreds of projects in, say, ALM, and they need to migrate that 100 projects data mm-hmm. from ALM to Qmetry. Mm-hmm. So they cannot do that through Excel import export. Mm-hmm. They need a tool, a utility which can help them mm-hmm. in this migration. And again, that's a migration framework is not a generic framework because everyone has their own implementation. And that framework keeps on evolving.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. So in your experience with your customers, what are the key benefits that, you know, they get if they migrate, you know, from a existing infrastructure and software testing tools to something like Qmetry?
Sure. So say, basically, we have this proven migration experience, right, for like 20 plus customers now. Mm-hmm. So we know how migration work from any tool, right, whether it's IBM, HP tool, or even tools like, say, SmartBay tools like Zephyr, or Tricentis tools like Qtest, right? So we do have those kind of experiences mm-hmm. Through our ready-made migration utility. Mm-hmm. Also, we have a dedicated support team, right? And at an additional extra cost or no cost to the customers sometimes, mm-hmm. right? So that is also available. And the basic idea is we don't want to make money on migration. We do the migration for customers for initial projects and then hand it over to them so that they can do the migration of entire instance mm-hmm. on their own. So we just do migration POC for them for mm-hmm. say 3 projects or 5 projects mm-hmm. and then they can do the entire migration by them. Okay. So it becomes an easier process that way. And all along this whole migration, our support team is already available for that.
Okay. So let's say if a customer has a partner, you know, who is supporting their infrastructure or who is, you know, who's basically taking care of their software testing, you know, as an outsourced partner. Do we have an example of such kind of an engagement where, you know, we enabled the partner to take care of this migration?
So our partners like Infosys or Column Technologies, right? We have enabled those partners with utilities and we have trained them. We have done joint migration so that they get trained on these processes and how they can be implemented for migration for different customers.
Okay, interesting. And so another question that comes frequently is what is the cost, right? Can you put a cost to it? You know, let's say you're offering the utility free or you're also helping the migration overall, but still, you know, there will be some notional cost apart from the tool cost. That one needs to consider. Do you have any idea around it?
So this cost depends on the scope of migration, right? Now that can vary from $15,000 to $50,000, right? Mm-hmm. Depending on what is the scope of migration. But and that's where it becomes very essential to identify with the customer teams that what needs to be migrated, what is the scope of migration, mm-hmm. and what are the artifacts that needs to be migrated. Mm-hmm. How do we need only current projects to be migrated? Do we want any archive projects to be migrated? So all those dependencies will define the cost, right? Mm-hmm. And as I said, it can be anywhere from $15,000 go to $50,000.
Mm-hmm. So I understood from you that, you know, Qmetry as a migration possibility or utilities available for HPQC, you also mentioned Zephyr, if I'm not mistaken, and mm-hmm. which are the other tools that, you know, we can look at for, you know, maybe using the REST API as well?
Yeah, yeah. So you can, so IBM Rational is another tool, then there are other tools like Qtest, and there is RecTest, and there are multiple tools out there, right? So, and that's where the open architecture, open API architecture that Qmetry has adopted to, that enables migration from any tool to Qmetry.
Okay.
So through APIs, you can do migration from any tool to any tool.
Okay. So while, you know, the focus has been on test management in this discussion at this point, but for Qmetry Automation Studio, is it still a possibility to migrate from other automation tools to Qmetry Automation Studio?
So Automation Studio is essentially an automation IDE, right? So say if you're using any IDE, whether you're using, as long as you're using Java, JavaScript, Python-based frameworks, right? The migration is seamless, right? Again, those can be, say, Selenium project, Appium project, Cucumber project, or any kind of framework that you're using, mm-hmm. right, will be supported as part of migration to Qmate Automation Studio. Mm-hmm.
So
not the UFT ones.
Okay. Okay, a couple of last questions from my end. So you know, in terms of migration, what kind of assets you know normally are migrated? You know, can you give me a more idea on that to our audience?
Sure. So usually, what we see is test cases are migrated, right? Test executions are migrated for historical reasons, right? Mm-hmm. And a lot of the times, defects are migrated as well. Mm-hmm. And the linkages is an important part. Sometimes it's easy to migrate the linkages. Sometimes it's difficult. But the linkages from, say, defect to test case or those things are also migrated.
Okay. So, you know.
And what, the reports, the metrics.
I was going to ask you that only. Thanks for bringing that up. Yeah.
Yeah, reports are very important as well. So, since you have the data, reports is easy part. Mm-hmm. And Qmetry gives you the capability of creating those reports. Mm-hmm. And in our next generation, we have this whole predictive analytics, right? So, and that's where the historical data is very important as part of that predictive analytics platform.
Cool. So I think, you know, yeah, you gave us a very good idea on Qmetry and, you know, the need of migration in today's time and age, and specifically with COVID-19, making this huge change at the workplace where, you know, everything has gone remote. I think it also makes sense to have this kind of a cloud-based or SaaS-based tool. Security is one concern, you know, that people would have. So I think, can you lastly address that aspect, before we close this session?
So security is a prime concern for everyone, right? If you look at Zoom.
Yeah.
they shot to fame with this whole work from home situation, right? Education institutions were using everyone is using Zoom. But then came this whole security flaw that nobody had encountered. Mm-hmm. So rather than being an afterthought, at Qmetry, we have included security as our utmost priority, right? Whether it being a HIPAA compliance for the medical industry, whether it being PCI compliance for finance industry, or even the ISO 27001, which is a standard for all across industries, right? And that has been a priority at Qmetry from the process perspective and security. And our teams regularly perform third-party audits, kind of vulnerability scans and all those things already as part of our regular processes. So security is an utmost priority at Qmetry, and we do take it very seriously.
Cool. Interesting. I think, you know, this has been a very good conversation, Harshal. You've given us a very good idea on how, migration from, moving from legacy to new age tools or more agile and DevOps oriented tools, how that will help in this current situation as well as overall in the coming future for large organizations. And I think you've answered most of the concerns and queries that such organizations have at this point in time. Thank you for your time. I hope you stay safe. Again, but I think that's most required. And still have a good time with your family. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you, Deepak. Thanks again.